All right, fans, here we go with our next bout of the evening. This is the co-main event of the evening. This is a six-rounder in the lightweight division. Making his way to the ring, fighting out of the blue corner. Fighting out of and representing San Jose, Costa Rica. Please welcome Bergman Aguilar.
He can mix it up.
And now making his way to the ring, his opponent fighting out of the red corner. El hijo de Pico Rivera, California. Please welcome Angel El Moreno Rodriguez.
Yeah. You talk about an entrance.
Oh, yeah. And we have a horse. Yeah. What's the name?
El Capricho.
Capricho.
So Angel Rodriguez coming in on his Capricho, his horse. We've seen some entrances before, but controlling your horse with your boxing gloves on.
I mean, Prince
and Nassim. Yeah, but Nassim wasn't riding a horse.
He rode everything.
Harvey
rides and whatnot.
El Moreno!
Wow. I thought I liked it at all, but this is interesting.
Well, we are at Pico Rivera Sports Arena, right there. Those are the stables.
That is true.
Mexico.
So, we know we've seen some extensive ring walks.
I mean, he's coming straight up to the ring. Oh, my. Are you think Canelo would ever do something like this? He loves horses. That could be for his next one against possibly Caleb Plant.
Get into the hands of his father,
El
Bartman.
Moreno!
Angel El Moreno Rodriguez.
Let's go, Barb Nation! Viva Mexico! Viva la raza!
El periódico un gallito para matar el frío. Es que me quedé en la calle sin familia. Mas la suerte llegó un día. Y a los 14 cumplidos en la mafia me metía. Aquí andamos a la sorda. Y el gobierno.
All right, fans, here we go with the co-main event of the evening. This is a six-round bout in the lightweight division. Your judges at ringside are Max DeLuca, Ron Stevens, and Damian Walton. Your referee in charge when the bell rings is veteran referee Ray Corona. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing red trunks. He officially weighed in at 138 3/4 pounds. He's a 23-fight veteran with 15 wins, 7 defeats, 1 no contest, 5 big wins coming by way of knockout. Fighting out of and representing San Jose, Costa Rica, please welcome Bergman Aguilar. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he's wearing beige with the Mexican flag trunks. He officially weighed in at 138 1/2 pounds. This fighter is undefeated with 8 wins, no losses, 5 big wins coming by way of knockout. El hijo de Pico Rivera, California. Please welcome Angel El Moreno Rodriguez. And now to give final instructions is referee Ray Corona.
Aquí está bien. This is good right here. If you want to touch gloves, do it now. God bless.
Ray Corona, the third man in the ring for Angel Rodriguez against Bergman Aguilar. Since the age is the big difference.
It's a very big difference. Two inch height difference, but it is a big age difference. But like I always say, you can't
get
nothing but a number.
Angel Rodriguez came in very confident riding a horse, a la Travieso Arce, who did that once, as Tim Boxale tweets us, let us know. Rodriguez, with the white gloves, has power. 8-0, 5 KOs, does work. El Moreno is his nickname. Hold the hand right immediately. Bergman keeps his hands low, Cynthia, so he is open for the big shot to be landed.
That's the edge.
Pico Rivera Sports Arena, this is a co-feature. Up next, Marc Antonio Barrera, Jesus Soto Garat in the exhibition. Took from Little Dominguez. Bergman looks like he's just a step slow at the age of 37.
Let go of his arm.
He is game, though. He'll make it ugly for you. Just a kind of veteran that has gloves, will travel. I'll take on anybody, anywhere. It don't matter. You got a young hot shot. No politics. Bergman must have fell second, but now he's covering up.
This is Angel Rodriguez. He fought in Texas, and he had a knockout that was so gnarly. Besides folding up
on the chair. He had a couple big highlight knockouts, so you can see how confident he feels. Yeah. His hands are down, but Burke can react with the right.
Look at him, the way Rodriguez stops him down. He knows he's very confident.
Gives it to the body.
Oh, but then he's not that mild. Like, bring it.
They're talking too.
Yeah, they are.
Bergman with a right.
But if you're going to talk, you better back it up.
Stay short, man. Be serious, son.
Hear that corner.
Yeah, you hear it.
Stay serious.
Beautiful jab, Rodriguez.
He's more of that.
Stealthy. Stealth jab. Lots of power behind him.
And Bergman in the corner is telling him the Rodriguez body shot. Bergman can be shot there. He can take the punch. The last fight when he went down was a body shot.
Fight off the road.
He's that savvy vet. He knows how to survive.
He does.
To make it over. But the last couple times that I've seen him, if his body shot had ended as an expert person, I would have. He could take a shot right there.
But can he take it?
He has it the last two times I've seen him.
He's good at talking Rodriguez.
He's 37.
He's 37, and Rodriguez has to be careful.
But that's something that you've seen this week that works a lot of shows. Is that when you come in, and then you try to play the mind game with the hot shot in the face.
Well, they have, that's what they have going, and they know that they can contest and pick them up and correct them. And here we go, here's a replay where Rodriguez is pulling off some shots, and he's taunting Bergman. But Bergman is doing that, making him do that. He's making him fight his type of fight.
Come on, man, I'm just grooving here.
What song is this?
Oh! Carmen! La Cadenita!
Huh? What's that? Let me find that in my Duolingo.
You got that. That's a jam, though. That's one of those, like, quinceañera.
Oh, yeah. I always hear it.
Wedding song.
Also dancing. I don't know the name of the song.
Yeah, it's when you get up and you're like, everybody's Tia's jamming, you know. Like they're jamming here at Pico Rivera. And then you see right in the middle of your screen with that tan coat is Marv Nation, Marvin Rodriguez. His son is in the ring right now. He actually has another young son he's fighting. This fight fell through. But Moreno Rodriguez, 8-0, 5 KOs. Moreno saying, come on, get over here. Overhand right. See how Bergman slips up? Bergman doesn't have the power anymore.
I was just going to say, he's more of a stick and move kind of guy. And
stick, move, try to steal rounds. That's his style.
He doesn't like to keep it in the middle of the ring.
No.
Yeah. He can't. He won't know what to do.
He has no power to trade with you, especially a young hotshot 21-year-old. But he can cut you.
Yeah.
It was the death of a thousand paper cuts. And he can make young fighters get frustrated. He sits in there the corner kind of egg you on. It's a good learning experience for Rodriguez. Bad body work. You see that? What I tell you, if you get to the body, that's a delayed reaction. He'll take the shot upstairs, but he won't take it back. Especially at 37. He stands up. The corner of Rodriguez telling him, don't rush.
Yeah.
Oh, we're dancing around. He's just trying to run. Digging in the body, and that tracks it for the second time in the round. Bergen caught in the same exact spot with body work by Moreno Rodriguez. Bourbon takes a deep breath. Very cool. This is from Denise. And let the veteran continue with 30 seconds. Can Rodriguez finish it in a second? Two body shots have dropped him. He goes back to the body. Digging to the body. Here's Rodriguez.
If you were in Bergman's corner, what would you be telling him?
Bergman pretty much trains himself. No, I'm serious. He comes with the corner, but he's been around for so long that he knows what he's doing, that he's just trying to keep it going. Bergman turned corner in 2008.
How you go?
Been around. He's done a lot of Thompson shows, the 360 shows. He's that club guy, and he's wincing. He's in pain. Maybe one more?
Maybe.
And he wouldn't be opposed if they stopped it.
I mean, how much more can he take of the body shot?
Oh, we can see that. And here's that delay. That's that, your body feels it, all of a sudden your brain is like, hey. And stop. The one that knocked him out for the second time. And Bergman's going to take every single second possible on that stool.
He's still hurt.
Oh, yeah.
You know that.
So we go to the third round. Aguilar was dropped twice. Angel Rodriguez looking good. Controlling this fight. It's a veteran Bergman Aguilar from Costa Rica.
Now Rodriguez is fighting with his arm down.
Bergman hasn't thrown any power punches at all.
But yeah, Bergman is still punching him.
Yeah.
I love it.
You're right, Rodriguez has his hands down.
Yo, it's he's out of time.
Which is what Bergman will not do.
Yeah.
You can ask him. Rodriguez wants to finish it. He's going to have to be first.
No power.
No. And no desire to mix it up either.
There's more time to go attack.
Yeah.
Rodriguez is playing it safe.
It's almost like he's letting him off the ropes a little bit. Body work. And that drops him. Is Ray going to stop it?
No. He's hurt.
Bergman is looking at the count. Drop. Third time with a body shot. Corner's telling him to go southpaw. Corner's telling him Rodriguez go southpaw. Will he be able to finish it here? From the southpaw stand. Dig. Digging body work.
Yeah, that's what he got.
That's it. And Moreno Rodriguez drops Bergman Aguilar four times and gets the KO in the third.
Well deserved. Showed off some of his skills, showed off his power punches. He showed that he listened to his corner when he said, don't rush it, don't rush it. He could easily just finish it right there, but he didn't.
The 21-year-old looked good.
Yeah, he did.
And Berman Aguilar, at the age of 37, body work, did him in four times, took shots to the right side of his body. Sportsmanship between the two.
Yeah. That was good. I mean, now we just, how much does Bergman have left in his tank?
Oh, he's that kind of guy who fights until 40-something. He'll find a way. He didn't get to know him. He loves boxing. He knows that it's his time to go up with these young bulls like Angel Rodriguez. But he'll take on the challenge. And Rodriguez, look at the day. Loaded on his horse. Leaves.
Literally, he came in on his horse. Just, oh my God. If you guys missed his ring entrance, you must go watch it. Cause, yeah. I mean, we are in a arena where there are horses. So it's common.
Yeah, the third round stoppage for Angel Rodriguez, who's now 9-0, 6 KOs for the gentleman.
Yeah, he has a bright future. He really represented Pico tonight. The fans have shown up. The crowd is here. But everyone is here getting ready for the next
big
exhibition. Exciting.
Babyface assassin Marco Antonio Barrera, Jesus Soto Caras coming up next. Main event. It's an exhibition.
It's an exhibition.
But they're getting ready to go.
No judges, no nothing, but can't wait to see what happens.
Hey, man. You know, Barrera, anytime you get in there. Of course, he the legendary fights with Eric Morales. And ring announcer, Marco Rodriguez.
All right, fans. 1 minute and 40 seconds in round number three. Your referee, Ray Corona, calls a halt to the bout for your winner by knockout victory. The fighting pride of Pico Rivera, California, Angel El Moreno Rodriguez.
And we'll be speaking with El Moreno briefly.
Congratulations.
Pico Rivera Sports Arena, return of the legends.
Jesus Soto Caras. They're going to be getting it on next, ladies and gentlemen. Our main event brought to you by Mar Nation Promotions. Yo, shout out to my man Mar. Mar, what good man?
And you see the highlights, Cynthia. It was a lot of body work from Angel Rodriguez, dropping him with the body work.
Really did. He went in and attacked with a flurry of punches, and Bergman was just not having it.
Yeah, four times he was dropped, veteran from Costa Rica, but it was too much. Angel El Moreno Rodriguez, as he gets the victory, he's sitting with us now, ringside cameras up there. Angel, you knocked him down with four different body shots. He's a veteran, he's tough, but your corner was telling you to get after it. You get the victory to stop in Chinese Field.
I feel great, man. It feels good to be back in my hometown right here in Pico and give everybody a good show, and I'm glad we won.
You got the victory, good crowd. The fight on the co-main right before Barrera and Soto Caras. That's cool, man. How's that feel?
Definitely. That's an honor for me, man. You know, Soto used to train me. I've always looked up to him, and this is a great fight.
And then for Barrera?
For Barrera, man, you know, he's an old school fighter. It wasn't in my days, but you know, I've seen him fight. He's a great warrior, somebody I aspire to be.
All right, now, Travieso Arce did it once where he came in on a horse. Dude, how do you ride your horse with your gloves on?
Yeah, it was scary.
Right?
Yeah, this is the second time I've done this.
There it is. So there it is. You're coming in, you're controlling him. Pero el caballo no quería como. He didn't want it.
No. Yeah, he got kind of scared. I got kind of scared, but
really?
I did because
he was bouncing around.
He started moving. And when we were coming in, he started like going to the side, but he calmed them down and we were good.
Where'd the idea come from?
You know what? My dad, this is the second time we did it here in October last year, and or the year before that. And I don't know, my dad just came up with it.
That's a cool. It's a definitely advantage in Repico Verde Sports Arena. They have that going on. It's always there. This atmosphere. How cool is it, man?
Alex Villanueva.
You know, I come here when they have all the bandas and all the stuff on Fridays.
Yeah.
So I know there's a good atmosphere. There's nothing but good vibes here, man.
Well, you gave the crowd something to cheer about. There's a camera. Send your shout-outs.
Marvin Rodriguez.
I want to thank everybody who came out here. I want to thank Coach Gil.
Let me tell you something.
Right here. Coach Gil right here.
That's right, Gil. You can get in the camera shot, man.
And you got.
I thought you got. Thank you, you got. All right, everybody else. I
started. There you go.
And Moreno, Angel Rodriguez gets the victory. He's now 9-0. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And the horse, Cynthia. The horse, he was scared.
I was scared for him.
The horse was moving around.
Savage Lifestyle, oh, the Billy Savages is in the building.
But he put on a show on the horse.
JR and the crew.
And then he put on a show.
Isaac Alvarez.
He's a future superstar.
What up, Isaac?
I can tell. I mean, he's very well composed, well spoken.
Designs, Eric Molina. And we put on.
And you know what? And the fans, he's a fan-friendly
a great
fighter.
Night of boxing,
and people loved
and
him.